We're moving the boat up. We're on the Peace River right now and moving up the boat upriver. It's really shallow water, so we're doing a lot of portaging. Selah's over there looking to see if you see some good rock, gravel. What do you see? Oh, a big fish just went by my foot.
I think this is pretty gravelly.
This is cool.
What is it?
It's a shell imprint.
Nice.
You're really shivering. I'm so sorry.
I'm cold too. Oops, it landed on my foot. Whatever.
They're landing on my foot. Whatever.
You doing that on purpose?
No. Enamel. I'm gonna put it to one side. Here's a shark tooth I just found in that. This is a stingray tail spine.
Nice.
My very first one.
That's awesome.
What do you think this is? This is, is this turtle or some other kind of shoot? Looks like turtle to me.
I think that might be part of a glycodon.
Yeah, it's hard to say.
I think we're gonna do a test sift here and see if we can find any shark teeth or fossils in this stuff. And it goes pretty far out.
Horse tooth.
Oh. I think these are different parts.
Look at this one. This one's kind of bashed up.
Why are you finding like 50 horse teeth in one thing? Or whatever. I just took this out of the water and I saw this giant stingray mouth plate. It's huge. This area must be good. Whoa, and there's another part of one. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, that's really nice.
What is it?
A big lemon shark tooth.
Nice, it's in good shape, yeah.
So we just got to this bank and I looked down and look what I saw. It's a tooth stuck in the limestone. Cool, right?
Ooh, look, little piece of horse tooth. See that?
See, look right there.
Where?
Right there.
Looks like a flounder. See how it has both eyes on one side? It's like a freshwater flounder. That's pretty cool. Well, I like here that there's all the layers and it's all eroding right out of this spot. And down in here is the clay, so you get all the groups, Hawthorn group, all the way up, different ages and everything. So it's really cool.
Hello, we're at the art lab back at home and we have all our fossils here we wanted to show you now. Yeah. You want to start?
Sure. We have a tortoise osteoderm. It is, for example, like turtle shell, but it like covers the tortoise and it is rounded on one side and it's pretty cool.
Alright, and here I have a horse tooth. This, we think it's equus. And to do these, we have some books. So we have this book right here, Florida's Fossils. This might help you out. Robin Brown did that one. And then this one is Fossiling in Florida. So a couple books are useful. And then
Mark Renz did that one.
And we also did we post in Fossil Forum. So there's a lot of available areas you can go to look for how to identify your fossils. And thanks to the people who helped us out.
This is a pufferfish mouth plate. It has layers of grinding surface. And this one is very cool because it has the lip teeth. So imagine the roof of your mouth was basically teeth, grinding teeth. And also your teeth in here would help grind your food. But that is like, it would go here. And I think that's amazing.
It's pretty cool. You like pufferfish?
Yes.
Yeah. All right, so here we have a soft shell turtle shell. And you can tell that because it's kind of got this wavy pattern on it. And so that's pretty cool too, to see. What else you got?
We have, so this we posted on the Fossil Forum and they thought that it was mammoth enamel. So like one of the ridges of a mammoth tooth would be this. We are not positive, but once we heard that, we agreed.
Because you can look and see how the enamel kind of squiggles around. It would be a big tooth.
Yeah, but we don't have the whole thing.
Right, just a little bit. But it just shows you probably in the river, if you're looking, there's going to be fragments of mammoth tooth. And that, you don't need to find a big one. Okay, so this is the tip of an alligator tooth, so a long time ago, alligator tooth fossil, just the tip.
This is a lemon shark tooth. It doesn't have serrations, and serrations are like a tomato knife has serrations, so it can cut into the tomato. This, they don't have serrations because they eat, I think, fish.
They don't eat tomatoes.
but like a great white shark tooth would have serrations.
So they eat tomatoes.
No. They eat bigger fish. And mm-hmm. I think maybe young whales.
Okay, so this one here kind of stumped us because it's not in any of these books, but this is the mold of a barnacle, and it's called a steinkern. So the
do it that way.
Yeah, well this is how it would be stuck on like this onto the surface, and then there's the barnacle, and so it stumped us, but somebody on the fossil forum helped us. So pretty cool.
We posted this too. It looked like a tooth, but then it didn't. And it's so small, and Peace River has both marine and land animals, so we had no idea.
But then we guessed it correctly, and then the Fossil Forum said that we were correct.
This is a barracuda tooth, or like a wahoo, is another of the things that could be
a similar fish.
And they're alive today, and I think it's cool that we have this.
Mm-hmm, for sure. So when I was out sifting, I found this one piece here. I was like, wow, that looks pretty cool. I didn't know what it was. And then on the next sift, I found this piece. And I said, whoa, they look like they might fit together. So I tried, and they actually fit together perfectly. So it's basically 1.5 inches of a tooth. And we weren't sure what kind of tooth, so we posted it on the fossil forum. And the best guess of everybody on there was that this is probably some kind of big cat. So a jaguar, puma, something like that. And this is just part of the tooth. The tooth would continue both ways. So it would be pretty long. And so that was really cool to find.
Yeah. This is some kind of fossil wood. It's curved here. So like if you're on a hiking trail, you might find a piece of wood that isn't just like a stick, but it's actually part of a big tree that has a ring that's broken. And then it has lines that are looking like wood.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, great. So that's what we have.
And
no. Oh, you have one more? Okay, yeah.
This is a giant. It's probably a little bit less than an inch long. We have a measuring thing there. But it would, just like the pufferfish mouth plate that has the lip, this doesn't have the lip, but it's the grinding tool. And I'm guessing it's an eagle ray. I just dropped it. And it would have these grinders that grind their food. And there can be ones that are like cemented together. So like this, and then another one, and then another one, and they'd all be on the roof of the mouth.
Awesome, we got some good stuff. Yeah.
Pretty. Please like, subscribe, share, and hit the notification bell.